Hello everyone, this is Karan here. You are welcome to Tech Karan YouTube channel. Today in this video, I'm gonna make a review of latest update of Evolution X custom ROM available for Redmi Note 8. This custom ROM is also based on Android 10. You get the security patch of 5th of February 2020. Also, you get the option to update your Google Play securities, like Google Play system update of 1st of February 2020, which you can just click and update from here. These are the things. This is the official build you get. How to install this ROM? Is Google camera working or not? What is the AnTuTu score? What is the Geekbench score? Everything in this video, so make sure you watch this video till the end. And now let's get straight to the video. Okay, as always, first of all, take a look at the launcher. And launcher is perfect. You are getting Pixel Launcher based on Android 10. Pixel Launcher official 10. Wait, let me show you. Pixel Launcher from Pixel 4 device. Version is 10. And by swiping right, you get the option of Google Pixel Feed, which is perfectly working. Google Pixel Launcher is great in this custom ROM. There is no issue at all, no bugs at all, no lagging problems. I didn't got any lag yet as of now, and performance is really smooth. By swiping down, you get the option of quick settings. Just go and edit from here. These are the quick setting tiles which you can add or remove from here, and here you only have the option of reset, nothing else. Other things which you get in this custom ROM is this camera, the normal Snapdragon camera, which you can see, and it is perfectly working. But Google camera 7.0 is perfectly working too, so it's better to use Google camera if you want to. If you're a fan of Google camera Gcam, just go and try it out. Google camera is perfectly working, so plus one for this custom ROM. Now let's take a look at the AnTuTu score. The AnTuTu score which you get in this custom ROM is 166,475, which is a very good AnTuTu score, I think better than some other previous ROMs. Another plus point. And now let's take a look at the Geekbench score. Geekbench score which you get in this custom ROM is super great and better than all other previous custom ROMs. Wait, sometimes if your app is stuck at this screen, this is because you're using Android 10 based custom ROM. So just force close that app once, clear app from recents, just open this app again, and then you will see this is the score you get in this custom ROM. 312 is a single core score, and multi core is 1361, which is I think one of the best score, one of the best Geekbench score which you have ever get in any custom ROM in Xiaomi Redmi Note 8, which is another great thing. And now let's take a look at some other features. Like, you get the option of recorder is a new app which is in only Evolution X based custom ROMs. Let's take a look at some settings. Now Google camera is working, and to the score I have shown you, Geekbench score I have shown you, and all other things. Now, and network and internet, you have the option of like normal things, Wi-Fi calling, etc. Adaptive battery option is only available. Battery charging level option is not available. Minus thing you can say, in display you have the option of night light, live display option is available, and dark theme which you can customize, which you can schedule from here. This is the feature available in Android 11 beta. If you have not watched my video regarding Android 11 beta, you can go and check it out on my channel. And dark theme, you can see, you can turn on from sunset to sunshine or turn on now. So dark theme is also customizable. Screen attention option is available, and double tap to wake and full screen apps. These are the options you get in display, sound, etc. In sound, you have the option of volume steps and vibration and haptics. Here you have the option of vibrate for calls, in call haptics, touch vibration, and ringtone vibration pattern. These are all the features available in MSM extended custom ROM also. And these features are available in this custom ROM also. You get the MI sound enhancer available. Another plus point, you get many extra features. You get also alongside that Pixel feel, security, accounts, digital well-being, all other things are almost same, no extra things. And Evolution settings, you get the option of themes, status bar, notifications, quick settings, power menus, gestures, lock screen, navigation, hardware buttons, animation, and miscellaneous. In themes, you have the option of accent color. If you are a lover of theming, you can just theme according to your own. And these are the fonts you get, whichever you like. I have chosen Slate for OnePlus, which are looking perfect. You can also choose icon shape, whichever icon shape you like, and status bar icons, which I've just shown you in MSM Extended Custom ROM. And header image, quick settings, header color, new tint style is also available. Enable the new quick setting tint style, default colors. You can also blur the quick settings behind like this. See, this is how you can blur it, but blurry is not look, doesn't look nice. Dashboard conditions, dashboard suggestions, these are the things you get here. Status bar, clock options, carrier label settings, network traffic, rounded corner, these are the options you get. Status bar items, status bar logo, battery style, etc. These are the many features available, just go and customize them. Notifications, edge lighting option is available, which is perfectly working. Other force close notifications and ambient display brightness is available. If you want to use ambient display, you can use it and ambient display is properly working. Quick settings, vibraton touch, battery percentage, brightness slider, columns, and this is where you can customize these quick setting tiles and quick setting footer text also. Edit icon, these are the things you get here. Power menu, you have the option of restart, advanced restart, screenshot, and other else things. In lock screen, you can customize anything, pocket detection, fingerprint authentication, vibration, status bar, clock widget option, charging animation option is available. In navigation, you have the option of system navigation, whichever you want. Like I am using gesture navigation, where you have the option of hide the navigation bar pill with the full gesture experience, and also you can choose to show the animated arrow for back gesture or not, which is your choice. And in miscellaneous, at last, animations, hardware buttons, animations, you can choose the quick setting tiles animation, list view animation, activity open, close, task, wallpaper, any animation if you want to use. Miscellaneous, you have the option of gaming mode, which you can customize, wake up on charge, screenshot type option is available, USB configuration option is available. And these are the main things: prevent accidental wake up, allow signature spoofing and sensor block per usage, do settings. And one thing I have just forgotten to show you, the kernel version which you get here is Genome kernel. You get Genome kernel by default, which is a great thing, and that's why it increases the performance of your device. Now let's take a look at some installation process, how to install this custom ROM on your device. You get the Google Apps pre-installed in this custom ROM with the ROM size of approximately 1.6 GB in size, and Google Apps are pre-installed, so you don't have to install it on your own. Just boot into custom recovery, and I hope you're using TWRP recovery on your device. Just decrypt your data once if you're encrypted like me. Decrypt your data by entering your pattern, password or PIN, anything which how you locked your device. Just open recovery, go to wipe, advanced wipe, Dalvik CAD system, enter data. After that, just go to install, and here you have to select the evolution x file. Just go to swipe to confirm flash, and as I told you, Google Apps are pre-installed. Just simply reboot, or if you are stuck at the logo, or if you are booting back to custom recovery, just format data once and everything will be done. This is how you have to format data YES and done. And this is after that your phone will be booted. This is how you can install Evolution X ROM on your device. So thanks for watching, goodbye, see you in the next video.